If you're here and you made vows, you know that you made a vow against yourself. Holy Spirit, I pray that you remind your people. You know that you made a vow against your life. You were angry or you were bitter like I was one time. And you spoke. Sharabagandus. Makarabakata labashata. Ramashanda rabagados. Rakarabashanda rabagadaya. Some of you were hurt in one church. You were serving in that church and maybe you got hurt. And you made a vow, I shall never serve again. And that closes doors of ministry for you. Maybe you got married in your first marriage and you were mistreated by your husband. You were mistreated by your wife. You were so much mistreated and demeaned and you said, oh my goodness me, I will never, never, never. Raise your right hand and say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I denounce. I denounce. Now listen, listen. When Simon Peter denied Jesus three times in the book of John, what did Jesus do to restore him back? He took him through confession three times. He asked him, Simon Peter, do you love me? He said, I love him. That canceled the first denial that he did. Simon Peter, do you love my sheep? That canceled. And he told him the third thing. Took a rest. Raise your hand and say, every vow that I made against my life, I take authority. I take authority today. I denounce that vow. I break that vow. I crush that vow. I paralyze that vow. I erase those words from the clouds in the name of Jesus. From the land in the name of Jesus. From the waters in the name of Jesus. I denounce those words. Masata, I take authority over them. Now, let me pray for you. Lord, in the name of Jesus, I take authority over every vow that was made by your people. I break those vows. I destroy those vows. Makara mako sataya. I stand in delegated authority to break those vows and to break the demons that have been empowering those vows. I command them to go. I command them to loose. I command them to go in the name of Jesus. I paralyze their works today in Jesus' mighty name. Now, listen. Do this. You know the vow that you made? I want you to three times declare a positive word. If you said, I will never get married, say, I will get married. Whatever you said, that was negative. Come on. Now, declare it three times. Authority over ancestral vows. These were personal, but they are also ancestral vows. Vows that were made by ancestors. And they say that anybody from our family, they will worship our children, our children's children, they will worship these gods. They will worship the trees, they will worship the mountains, they will worship the gods of the seas, they will worship the marine powers, and so on. And they made a vow that anybody that moves away from that, let them be accursed. That opened a portal for demonic powers to follow everybody that comes from that lineage. So, in some families, elders make vows and they say, none of our sons shall marry a woman from that tribe or from that tribe. Anybody that ever gets married to anybody from that tribe, let them be accursed. They make that vow. My grandfather made such a vow. There was a particular time because there was one of his sisters was killed by a people from a particular tribe in Uganda. And my grandfather was so bitter. And he said, nobody, my children, my grandchildren, my great-grandchildren, and so on, should ever get married from that tribe. Those who tried, it never worked. Because they didn't have authority to break those kind of vows. So, you could be here, you're married, but your marriage is having storms and so on because there were vows that were made. You know, when I was preaching this morning, the Lord revealed to me that there was somebody in the service, two people in the service, a man and a woman. One man was planning to get married to the lady, and the parents of the man went to altars to stop that marriage. But because it was the will of God, it took place. But that marriage has had a lot of attacks, you know. And also a lady had the same issue. Ancestral vows. They fight people. Why do you think that we are having challenges in our country where people cannot accept certain tribes? It is vows that have been made by ancestors. So that when you want to marry somebody from that tribe, you know, there's just a force. Say, with this one we accept it amongst our people. Some of you annoyed your parents because your parents were not born again. They swore, you will never prosper. Especially in families where it is a polygamous setting and your mama was not the beloved of your dad. Vows. Your dad vows, you child, you will never prosper. You're going nowhere. Now, I'm not here to scare you. What I'm here to tell you is, child of God, the authority that we have been given destroys those vows. Those vows are useless. They can only continue if you don't exercise your authority. You have greater authority. Raise your hand and say, Father, in the name of Jesus, every vow that was made by my ancestors against my life, I break those vows. They are useless. They are powerless. I destroy them today in the name of Jesus. I exercise authority. Powerless. Makasata, open your mouth. Pray in the spirit. Destroy every vow. 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 Ancestral vows. Destroy them today. Makasanda bagadaya. Remako prekato zataya. Manda shata bagadusa. Rika talabashanda rabagadusa. Baka prekataya. Mandele besete. Rika talabashata. Mandolo boseke prekataya. Rima shanda bagadaya. Mako prekataya. Rima saka rabakato. Bako prekataya. Masata magaduza. Bako prekataya. Rima sunda bakataya. Rima shanda bakataya. Every vow against your marriage, against your marriage, I destroy every vow against your marriage. I destroy every vow against your children. I destroy every vow against your progress. I destroy every vow. Masata Ramakataya. Some of you visited witches and they told you to take money and you refused. And they vowed you shall never prosper. I take authority over those vows. They are useless. They are powerless. In the name of Jesus, Makarabasanda. I stand on this pulpit even to pray for the nation of Kenya. I decree any vow that was ever made against any vows, Any vow that was made against any people group that they can never rise up, I break those vows. I stand as a prophet of God to destroy every vow made on national level that some tribes shall never arise in Jesus' name. I declare you are going to rise. You are going to rise. Can I hear a better amen? You are not going to rise, but you are rising. I say you are rising. You are rising from now. You are rising from today. Nothing can hinder you. That is authority. That's authority. You know, some of you were cursed even by the so-called men of God. You know, there are men and women of God who curse people. And they swear and they say, because you've left me, you will never prosper. That is useless. That is useless. No man of God has a right to curse you. You are blessed. Don't be scared. Don't be intimidated. No man of God has authority to curse you. If there be any vow against you by a man of God, I break it. I destroy it. Three, authority over evil dedications. There's so much to share. Some people were dedicated when they were young. Okay. Let me finish with this one. Husbands have authority over their wives. Ephesians chapter 5, verse 23 to 25. For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church, and he is the savior of the body. Therefore, as the church is subject unto Christ, so let the wives be unto their husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it. Now, the authority that God has put upon men over their wives is not an authority to mistreat and step on your wife and remind her every time, hey, I'm the head, praise the Lord. Eh? Hey, where is my honor? Where is my respect? If I be the man of the house, where is my respect? You ladies of Kenya, you are mushukuru Mungu. If you are Ugandan, praise the Lord. You have to kneel down. Sebo. 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 Nyinyi mulipona, praise the Lord. Mulipona, Mungu aliwasamee. You know, you just stand up and talk to your husband. Wewe. Sukari umeleta. Kwani nina sahau baba Kamau nilikwambia ulete sukari imeisha. I'm not talking about these ladies. These were super. I'm talking about the ladies outside there. The authority that God has given us as husbands over our wives is one to love them. Is authority to love. No other man should love your wife. Men, you mean you cannot say men to that? Eh? Josiah. Josiah, no other man should tell Monica anything. Josiah Anatosha. Let me tell you, a woman, there is no love, apart from the love of God, that can satisfy a woman apart from the love of their husband. Even if the father says, I love you, I love you, I love you, the brothers, I love you, a million times, there is a gap. But when the man of the house says, my sweetheart, I love you. Ay. She feels she's... That's why you see, girls get so excited when they are being dated. The day they have been suggested to. Here, when I look at my daughters, najua ule ameambiwa hiyo neno. Najuanga. Najuanga. Papa! Papa! Najua kuna kitu ime drop. Kuna kitu ime drop. Love, the love of a husband, and that's an authority that God has bestowed of us. If you're sitting next to your wife, tell your wife, I love you. You are my... Hey, now people are not seated with their wives. Now some of you feel ashamed to tell your wife, Mama, my dear, I love you, sweetheart. You look wow. Hoo-ha-ha-ha. Hallelujah. Leo watanipatia chakula minji. Ukitaka mama atoe pesa mahali ameficha. Mwambie tu hiyo maneno. Chakula itaiva saa sita. So, that is authority to love. That's why the Holy Spirit emphasizes men love. Love your what? Love your wives. Because women love that. We have also been given authority to protect them. Authority to protect. Adam did not do it. That's why she was tempted. Adam was to protect her. Because sisters can easily be deceived. Easily. Hallelujah. Easily. You know, wengine hata, especially some of my daughters here, praise the Lord, counterfeit guys come to them. There's one who came and told one of them, oh, I love you. I'm marrying you. She came to my office. God has answered. Said, yes, tell me now. God has answered. Okay. Tukaongea. Ta 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 ta. I said, oh, glory to God. A few days after that, the wife of the guy comes to my office. Says, Pastor, my husband has been coming to this church. I've followed him today. I said, who is your husband? Say, that guy. You know? That's why, I mean, you need counsel. Sisters can easily be deceived. We have a responsibility to protect our wives. Those who are married, you have a responsibility to pray because you have authority. You have a mantle of... Because the spiritual realm honors authority. The angelic kingdom, the way it operates, angels, different angels have different responsibilities over different clusters of angels. And angels specifically report to their leader. They don't report to any. The demonic kingdom also has its hierarchy. God ordained the man as the priest of the home. So we must take our position, pray for our wives, and so on. If your husband is not born again. Now, if your husband is not born again, and you're a sister and you're born again, you also have authority over him, because the Bible says the man is sanctified by the wife and the wife is sanctified by the man. Because of your sanctification as a sister, your husband also gets sanctified. It doesn't mean that he doesn't have to get born again, but it means that he, you know, there is a limit in the forces of darkness that can attack him because of you. The husband of a sister who is born again is not on the same level with the husband of a woman that is not born again. This man has a certain level of protection because of the sanctification by the wife. Praise the Lord. I finish with this word. Sisters, women have been given authority to submit to their husbands. It is an authority over the women. To love, to submit, not to do it grudgingly. When a woman submits to the husband, you've never seen the beauty. Hey. But when a woman is controversial, hallelujah, controversial. Unajua kuna kwanga na controversial wives. You say, the chair should be here, it should be there. Those kind of women, even when they make calls, their husbands are trembling. Hey, Babo Cheng, where are you? Oh, I'm in the traffic jam. I'm coming. Don't care. After 5 minutes. Yani, traffic jam imekuwa namna gani leo? Jezebel. But they are not here. Praise the Lord. The beauty in a woman is submission. I can tell you. If you want to pull down a man, hallelujah, and flatten him completely, submit. And the women said no, because they are quiet. Hallelujah. Submit. But if you are like Amope, those of you who did literature, you remember that woman called Amope. There are men. I used to have a friend of mine when we could go for ministry. He's so happy. We enjoy. The day we finish, we used to come back on Monday. I asked him one day, we're in the bus, what is wrong? You're not happy. I'm so happy. I'm going back home. Hey, you man, I'm going back to fire. Praise the Lord. God has given ladies that authority, the authority of submission. Submission is a weapon. It is a weapon by itself. So we want to pray. Let's stand up. Let's just take a few minutes to pray. Worship team, come over. Thank you, Jesus. Rasharabagaraya. Just open your mouth and pray. Recover your authority. If you lost your authority, recover it back. Recover back your authority. Recover back your authority. Rakashaka, recover back your shoes of authority. Recover back your shoes of power. Maka, authority, authority. Oh. A dedication is a covenant. Declare and say, I denounce every evil covenant and every dedication that was made over my life through my names in the name of Jesus. I pray for my children. I break all evil associations. evil dedications. I destroy them by fire. In Jesus' name. Let me pray for you. Lord, I pray for your people. I come against all evil dedications that were done unconsciously against their lives. I break them. I break them. I destroy them. I break every evil dedication in the name of Jesus. I destroy them by the power of the Holy Ghost. Makaramashanda. Zanda. And some of you are living in houses that were dedicated to powers of darkness, and you've had affliction in that house. Today, I destroy those dedications. I destroy those dedications. I destroy those dedications. I send the fire of God to your house. I send the fire of God to your house to consume every altar, to consume every covenant, to consume every power of darkness in the name of Jesus. Mashana, some of you are working in offices where covenants were made by people that nobody else should arise. Today, I take authority as a servant of God to destroy those dedications against your life in the name of Jesus.